The LibreOffice color palette is used for font color, highlighting, and the background color. It's the same palette to all of these features. Although there's nearly 100 different colors, there are still times when you might want to customize one of these colors or add in your own color. To change our color palette, we'll need to go into Tools, Options, then into Colors. To change a color, we need to choose one. I'll choose this black in the upper left-hand corner. We see black and black. These are our colors. Our red, green, and blue, RGB, are all set to 0. Perhaps I'll change this to 255. And now we've changed the color to red. This was your original color. This lower one is the proposed color. Now, if I want to update this to be the new color, I just click on Modify, and that will change this. I don't want to change the color, so to go back to the original color, I just click on it once again. It resets all the colors and our name back to black. Now I want to make a custom color. I'm going to call this Custom Blue. I can create this just by typing in these RGB numbers, if I know what they are, 255, and we can see the new proposed color is this blue color. I can also click Edit, and it brings up this color chart. Now, how this works is, it's put this little dot where my custom color is right now. Now, it's probably tough to see. Let me zoom in. Perhaps you can see this now, this little dot here. And I can drag this around and make this whatever color I see in here. To the red, to the blue, to the green, back to red. Now this is telling me the new proposed color. If I click OK right now, it'll be this purplish color. We also have this color chart here that we can kind of play with. To choose this color red, I would click this right arrow saying bring this circle to where this color red is. Clicking the arrow, we see it turns right to red. I can change it to this blue that's in this corner, and it's that blue right there, 255. Can make it the green. Now there's another arrow. To use this, I can take my little ball here, my little dot, place it into a color, then click the left arrow, and it turned this corner into this color right here. And I can drag this down to the white, and if I make this corner white, now click the left arrow, it brings this white to this side and gives me a little change of colors there, more to choose from. Then I'll say, okay, maybe I like this color right here. I'll click it back from the left to the right. And now I've got this orange color. These three in the center, the red, green, blue, those are the same that are on the other RGB that we saw on the dialog box just before this. The cayenne, magenta color and key, these, you can play with them and it changes the colors, but they all come down to whatever these three are. The only ones that may play a little different are maybe this brightness. If I turn this way up, we can see it going higher, or I can bring it down. See, now there's no real white color on here, though, for me to drag into. But that doesn't mean that it's not available. I would just click this white in the corner here. Or I could type in the numbers, I can lower these numbers. That's just different ways to play around to get the color choice that you want. Going back to my custom blue, I'm going to make it this very light colored blue and click OK. And let's zoom out. To create my new custom blue color, I'm going to click Add. We see it added it right here. Clicking back into black, it's black. Here's my new custom blue, my new color. I can modify this color. I can edit, going bringing up that color wheel, or I can type in the numbers here. I want to add another custom color. We'll call this custom red. I'll make it similar to this red color here. Notice when I click that red, it blew away my title, so I need to type that in again. And to change things around, we'll make this one 200 and this one 200. So there's my custom red. I'm going to add that. We need to scroll down to see it. So I got my custom red and custom blue. If I don't like this custom blue, I can delete it. Clicking this delete, it gives me one more chance to say, do you really want to delete this color? I'll say yes. Now that's gone, our custom red is in the lower right. Clicking OK. Looking at our color palette for our background color, we see in the lower right, custom red. But what happens if I had left that custom blue in there? Let me add that back in real quick. Now when we look at the background color, we need to scroll down, but it's on the next row. It is also in our font color, and it is also updated in our spreadsheet calc. Here it is, custom red and custom blue.